सीधे आपको चेन्नई लेकर चलते हैं, जहां पर डिफेंस एक्सपो में प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी बोल रहे हैं।
तमिलनाडु, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी हियर इन द लैंड ऑफ द ग्रेट चोलास हु एस्टैब्लिश इंडियाज हिस्टोरिक लिंक्स थ्रू ट्रेड एंड एजुकेशन। दिस इज द लैंड ऑफ अवर ग्लोरियस मैरिटाइम लीगेसी। This is the land from where India looked east and acted east thousands of years ago. Friends, it is wonderful to see over 500 Indian companies along with over 150 foreign companies present here. More than 40 countries have sent their official delegations as well. It is an opportunity like none other, not only to discuss India's defense requirement, but also to showcase for the first time ever in such a manner India's own defense manufacturing capabilities to the world. Armed forces the world over know the importance of supply chains, but it is not just on the battlefields but also on the factory floors of defense manufacturing enterprises that strategize decisions are made. Today we live in an interconnected world. The efficiency of supply chain is a key factor in any manufacturing enterprise. Therefore the strategic imperative to make in India, to make for India and to supply to the world from India is stronger than ever before. Friends, thousands of years of history of India shows that we have never desired anyone's territory. Rather than winning countries through wars, India has believed in winning hearts. This is the land from where the message of peace and universal brotherhood has gone out since Vedic times. This is the land from where the light of Buddhism spread to the world. In fact, from the time of Ashoka and even earlier, India had believed in using strength to protect the highest ideals of humanity. In modern times, more than 130,000 Indian soldiers sacrificed their lives in World War in the last century. India had no claim on territory, but Indian soldiers fought for restoring peace and upholding human values. Independent India has also sent one of the largest numbers of UN peacekeeping keepers to places all over the world. At the same time, an important responsibility of the state is to protect its own citizens. The great Indian thinker and strategist Kautilya wrote the Arthashastra more than 2,000 years ago. He said that the king or the ruler must protect his people And he also said that peace is preferable to war. India's defense preparedness is guided by this thought. Our commitment to peace is just as strong as our commitment to protect our people and our territory. And for this, we are ready to take all steps required to equip our armed forces, including through the establishment of a strategically independent defense industrial complex. Friends, we are conscious that creating a defense industrial complex is far more from simple. We know that a lot needs to be done and many pieces of this puzzle need to fit together. We are also aware that the defense manufacturing sector is unique in terms of government involvement. You need the government to grant a license to manufacture. Since the government is almost the only buyer in India, you also need the government to grant an order. And you need the government even to grant permission to export. Therefore, over the last few years, we have made a humble beginning on defense manufacturing licenses, on defense offset, on defense exports, clearances, on foreign direct investment in defense manufacturing, and on reforming our defense procurement, we have taken many steps. In all these areas, our regulations, processes, and procedures have been made more industry-friendly, more transparent, more predictable, and more outcome-oriented. The defense product list of the purpose of issuing licenses has been revised, and most of the components, parts, subsystems, testing equipment and production equipment have been removed from the list to reduce entry barriers for the industry, especially for the small and medium enterprises. Initial validity of industrial license has been increased from 3 years to 15 years, with provision to further extend it by 3 years. Offset guidelines have been made flexible by allowing changes of Indian offset partners and offset components even in contracts already signed. Foreign original equipment manufacturers are not now required to indicate the details of Indian offset partners and products at the time of signing of contracts.